Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling a story between Sulaiman and a bird called Al-Hudhud. In English, it's called Hoopoo. Sulaiman alayhi salam is marching with his soldiers, birds and jinn and you name it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتَفَقَّدَ الطَّيْرِ فَقَالْ مَا لِيَ لَا أَرَى الْهُدْهُدْ أَمْ كَانَ مِنَ الْغَائِبِينَ. Now I want you to imagine this whole army, and Sulaiman noticed that there is one bird missing. Some of the scholars said he needed the hudhud every time he travels, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this hudhud something that nobody has. And this bird can see what's under the ground just like he sees what's above the ground. And he can tell Sulaiman, okay, you want water for your army? There's water right here. He can see under the ground the water just like he sees the water above the ground. So he missed him. But at the same time, he said, maybe he has an excuse. أَمْ كَانَ مِنَ الْغَائِبِينَ. He's absent maybe for a reason. And then he said, لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا أَوْ لَأَذْبَحَنَّهُ أَوْ لَيَأْتِيَنِّي بِسُلْطَانٍ مُبِينٍ. I'm gonna torture him unless he comes with a valid, clear excuse. فَمَكَثَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ. After a very short period of time, the Hudhud came back. And immediately he said, أَحَطْتُ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ. Wow, I came to you with news that you do not know. I found out about something that you, the king, you, the prophet of the time, do not know. أَحَطْتُ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ وَجِئْتُكَ مِنْ سَبَأ بِنَبَأٍ يَقِينٍ. And I came back from Sheba, from Sabah, with 100% authentic news. Look at the humbleness of the leader, that he's listening to a bird to present his excuse. What is the excuse? What did you see, Mr. Hudhud? He said, إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ امْرَأَةً تَمْلِكُهُمْ وَأُوْتِيَتْ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَلَهَا عَرْشٌ عَظِيمٌ. I was flying over Sabah and I saw a group of people. They're led by a queen. And she has min kulli shay. In Arabic, if you just want to literally translate it, she has everything. But here, kulli shay in Arabic, it means that she has everything that a king have. وَلَهَا عَرْشٌ عَظِيمٌ. So if someone is used to the arsh of Sulaiman and saw the arsh of Balqis and said, it's arshun azim, she has arsh azim, she has a great throne. What's the problem? وَجَدْتُهَا وَقَوْمَهَا يَسْجُدُونَ لِلشَّمْسِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ فَصَدَّهُمْ عَنِ السبيل فهم لا يهتدون. What is bothering you, Mr. Hudhud? He said, I found these people with their queen making sujood to the sun and not to Allah. And the shaitan beautified this to them, so they are not guided. Why is that bothering you? Listen, Allah yasjudu lillah. They're making sujood to the sun. Why they're not making sujood to Allah? Who's Allah to you, Ya Hudhud? الذي يخرج الخبأ في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تخفون وما تعلنون. For the bird, what came to mind when it comes to Allah, he is the one who brings the clouds. The clouds bring down the rain. The rain brings the vegetation. And then I get my share of 2 grains of wheat. He's the one who brings the things that are hidden, bring them out. This is the biggest ni'mah that the Hudhud felt. For 2 grains of wheat and the nest, he felt that no one should worship other than Allah. Because of this small ni'mah, 2 grains of wheat fill up his stomach, and the small nest, he felt that this is a huge, great ni'mah from Allah, that because of this ni'mah, I only should worship him. And that bothered him and killed him. This bird is flying 2,000 kilometers from Sulaiman to Yemen. And it's a bird. What attracts the bird? The beautiful scenery. And how beautiful is Sabah? لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَئٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ نتان عن يمين وشمال. Allah told us how beautiful is Sabah. Gorgeous, 2 gardens from the left, from the right. Beautiful. Ya Hudhud, all this beauty did not attract you. All this distraction did not attract you. All you saw that are people making sujood to the sun, and that bothered you. You noticed that there are people committing shirk, and that killed you.
How many times we get bothered when we see people committing shirk around us? Now look at the great king. Even though he said, I am coming with certain news, he said, سَنَنْظُرْ أَصَدَقْتَ أَمْ كُنْتَ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ. I'm going to double check if you're telling the truth or you're lying. اذهب بكتابي هذا فألقه إليهم ثم تولى عنهم فانظر ماذا يرجعون. Go, take this message from me, give it to them and wait. Stay from far and see how they respond to my message. My brothers and sisters, the bird was the reason for the whole kingdom of Sheba to become Muslim. Now what is the reward for this Hudhud because of his amal? Because of what he did. It's haram to kill a Hudhud. One Hudhud did something good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it haram to kill any of the species till the day of judgment.